fermented digestions present the goal of helping people feel better and feel better all over the world. It's asked the doctor, and board certified optimistic professional, certified nutritional specialist, and popular radio host, Dr. Michael Love of Bowel Macular Association. Good morning, and welcome to Ask the Doctor. I'm your host, Dr. Michael Lange of the Lange Diet Institute and Fortify Vitamins, here each and every Saturday morning live to answer any and all questions you may have regarding your vision, eye care, or a nutritionally related topic. I'm a board-certified optometric physician. I'm also a certified nutritional specialist. I've been hosting Ask the Doctor since 1993 on multiple radio stations throughout the entire country. You can actually watch me live video streaming right now at News Talk Florida. So you can check us out on 8:20 a.m. Right here out of the Tampa Bay market, certainly 97.3 FM up in the Gainesville, Ocala, Lake City market, 1440 AM in Montgomery, Alabama, Atlanta, 640 WGST, Atlanta, Georgia. A lot of other radio stations are picking us up, so if you hear me and you have a question regarding your vision and or eye care or a nutritionally related topic, pick up the phones and give me a call. This is a live show. This is sometime early February. I am live. I apologize. Last week I was in Las Vegas at a conference. So the phone number is 866-977-4820. 866-977-4820. Participation is encouraged. I also want to thank our new listeners in Montgomery, Alabama, and in Atlanta, Georgia. I want to thank them for tuning in and listening, and also for being customers for Fortify Vitamins. You can learn a lot about what we have to do, the nutritional products I've developed, a lot of the science and the research and the studies at fortify.com. Fortify is F-O-R-T-I-F-E-Y-E, fortify.com. Also, for those of you, I'm going to give you a special discount. Write that down right now, a discount code. If you buy three things on Fortify Vitamins, so you're on the new Lange diet and you're taking the Fortify Super Protein, the Fortify Super Food, Blue Green Superfood, and the Omega 3 and or the Focus, you get 20% off if you go to the coupon section at checkout and put LEC 20% in. So write that down, LEC 20 and then the percent sign. At checkout, there's a coupon code section. Put that in. Anytime you buy three or more, you're going to get 20% off. All right, one more time. Phone lines are open, 866-977-4820. Let's go to the phones. I wonder who's first. Good morning, Bob in Ocala. What can I do for you?
Good morning, Dr. Lange. Welcome back. Welcome back.
I'm glad to be back.
I read an article, actually a week ago now, about omega-7.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I gotta claim some ignorance here. I'm pretty well versed in omega-3, omega-6, and omega-9. First question is, how many omegas are there, and what is the function of omega-7, and are they all essential fatty acids?
Yeah, there are a variety of omegas. I mean, you have omega-3, omega-6, omega-7, omega-9, omega-8 now. I don't know how many more there are. You know, I got to tell you, omega-7 is relatively new. Scientists recently uncovered the specific omega-7. It's actually called palmitoleic acid, right? And Harvard has actually had a lot to do with this omega-7. And, it's very similar to omega-3 in what it does. It lowers inflammation in the body. The big thing is it's involved in the metabolic syndrome, right? When you're overweight and you have high blood pressure, poor circulation. Omega-7 has been shown to be beneficial for people with type 2 diabetes, atherosclerotic plaque building up, C-reactive protein, like I said, inflammatory markers in the body. So I don't think there's enough information, enough studies promoting omega-7 right now. I mean, the big thing, if you Google it on the internet, It's all about fighting metabolic syndrome, okay? Which is usually people that are insulin resistant, you know, elevated glucose, people with high cholesterol, their lipids are out of whack, high blood pressure, and they're fat, okay? You can pinch more than an inch, so they have a lot of inflammation in their body. So this is what omega-7 is, but, you know, it's still kind of on the early cutting edge. And like I said, I'm not an expert in omega-7 yet because, quite frankly, I haven't seen a lot of good double-blind placebo-controlled studies like omega-3, all right? But it is something I think we will talk more about in the future because, you know, we're starting to get a few more calls regarding omega-7.
Excellent. Okay. Well, as always, we'll still stay tuned and wait for an update on omega-7. Good to have you back, Dr. Lang. Lord Willow, we'll talk to you next week.
Good to be back, Bob. You take care. Bye-bye. Yeah, I was in Las Vegas at a nutritional conference talking to doctors from all over the world about proper nutrition for their patients. The Fortify Vitamin Company was sponsoring it. I got to tell you, you know, I had a half day off, so instead of just hanging out at the casinos and gambling, I went to the Las Vegas Speedway, and I took a four-hour course on racing cars. Did I really need to do that is the question. Could get expensive, and I'm hooked. You know, I used to race competitive motocross. A lot of you know that. Had a bad accident, injured my body really bad. And the other day I was riding around a little course I have, a little track at my house in Ocala, and almost had a bad wreck. And I started thinking, you know, I need four wheels on the ground. I need a roll cage around me. So I took this race course. Well, I'm so hooked to it. In a couple of weeks, I'm going to head to the Bondurant School of Racing in Arizona, and they let you race where you learn on Viper TAs that are set up for the track and Formula One race cars. So I'll let everybody know after I come back. I'll be there for a week. We're going to have a live show next week, but then I will be gone in Arizona, so we'll have to run a tape for that one. But I'll let everybody know if I'm really addicted, if I'm going to start. Who knows? Maybe I'll become a Formula One race car driver. All right, phone lines are open, 866-977-4820. You're listening to Ask the Doctor. Remember, any nutritionally-related topic or an eye-related topic, you can give me a call at 866-977-4820. I'm going to give you the phone number. Write this down. This is for Fortify Vitamins. You can call Monday through Friday up till 5:30 in the evening. If you live in Ocala, you can certainly go by Fortify Vitamin headquarters right there on 17th Avenue. You can't miss the sign right out front. And we're next to Would You. The phone number for Fortify Vitamins is 866-503-9746. And we'll honor the 20% off if you say you heard us on the radio. That's 866-503-9746. And go to fortify.com. F-O-R-T-I-F-E-Y-E. Fortify.com. A lot of you have been wanting me to come out with a diet. I've been working on a diet for macular degeneration for years, and I've seen what works and what doesn't work. So I did develop a diet. I'm calling it the Lange Diet. And you can actually get a copy of the Lange Diet on the website. A better copy is going to come out soon. If you go to fortify.com and go to news, you can print that right off. And what it is a meal plan. It's a weekly meal plan. It tells you exactly what to eat for breakfast, what snack to have, what to have for lunch, what snack to have after lunch, and what to have for supper. It even talks about water and apple cider vinegar, probiotics. It talks about how we use Fortify Focus, which has astaxanthin in it, and Fortify Super Omega to speed up your metabolism and actually help you to lose weight even faster. This is a paleo diet. It is gluten-free, and it is FODMAP-free. It has fermented foods in it. There is no red meat and no pork. There is fish. There is chicken. There is turkey. There's eggs. There's a lot of green vegetables, a lot of salmon in it. There is no pasta, bread, rice, or potatoes. I let you have quinoa, special grain, twice a week. So it really works. I've had patients that have lost in between 5 pounds and 14 pounds in 1 week on this diet. The diet also consists of Fortify Super Protein and Fortify Blue Green Superfood as one of your meals each day. That's what helps you be very healthy and lose weight safely but rapidly. So I got to tell you, one of the most important aspects of good health, the most important aspect of good health and anti-aging is optimal weight. If you're overweight, you're more prone to have macular degeneration, glaucoma, cataracts, dry eye, diabetes, hypertension, cholesterol problems, elevated inflammation in the body, C-reactive protein, homocysteine, cancer. You're more prone to have a heart attack, more prone to have a stroke, osteoarthritis. Need I go on? So if you're overweight, if you can pinch an inch or more, you got to lose weight. I got to tell you, I got to practice what I preach. I have lost 17 pounds in 1 month on this new Lange diet that I've created. I got to lose about 8 more, and I'll be where I want to be. So by the time I get in that race car in 10 days, I'm going to be at my ideal body weight, which is about 188. All right, we're getting to go to phones. Some people have been waiting patiently. Let's see who is first. Let's see. I think it's Steve. Steve in Bradenton. Good morning.
Good morning. How we doing?
I'm hanging in there.
The Viper you mentioned, I think they go over 200 miles an hour, don't they?
Oh, yeah. And it's going to be the new Viper ACR Extreme, which actually has 2,000 pounds of downforce at 150 miles an hour. It holds the track record right now on all the tracks in the United States. So it'll be kind of exciting.
That's going to be a rush, isn't it?
I got to have a little adrenaline every now and then, you know. That's my theory. Adrenaline is anti-aging. It releases beta endorphins. That's the feel-good endorphins. So it's good at fighting against inflammation. It's good against fighting against depression. You think about it, cortisol is inflammation. So in a roundabout way, you know, going over 150 miles an hour is going to lower inflammation in my body. Well, that's a theory I have.
It's like giving yourself a prescription there.
There you go.
My question is about detached retinas.
Mm-hmm.
And once you have one and it's repaired, is there a tendency for it to happen again? Since I've got a long eye, I was very nearsighted my whole life.
Right.
Does it happen again, or once it's fixed, it's in there?
Yeah, so your axial length, the length of your eye is very long. That's why you're so nearsighted or myopic. And that creates a lot of tension and stretching on your retina. So I've got to tell you, just because you had one retinal attachment doesn't mean you're not going to have another one. Now, if they do a scleral buckle or they seal it with a laser or cryotherapy, a lot of times it's going to be packed down very well, and it oftentimes will not detach at that location, but it could detach at another location. So it all depends how good the retina specialist was that did the work on the eye. And as a rule of thumb, all right, if you probably are aware, Steve, you have to be cognizant of the first signs and symptoms of a retinal tear or retinal detachment. A sudden onset of flashing lights, thousands of floaters, a curtain or a veil coming over your vision. Get into your optometrist or ophthalmologist. Have your eyes dilated immediately. If it happens at 3 o'clock in the morning, I don't recommend going to the emergency room. You know, just wait and go and see your doctor first thing in the morning.
And my other question is, doing things like playing basketball or tennis or something, and you're jarring, this sounds stupid, but you're jarring your eye and stuff, is there a tendency for the retina to come off more that way, or does it not matter?
Well, no, there probably is. So I don't recommend kickboxing. I don't recommend barroom brawls. But, heck, you've got to play basketball. You got to do some sports. You got to be active. And I wouldn't go through life, you know, being concerned about that. But contact sports I would be concerned about, all right? But no, basketball could be obviously a contact sport. Wear protective eyewear. You know, rec specs, there's good protective, you know, goggles when you're playing basketball, so you don't get an elbow in the eye. Same thing with tennis. If you've had a retina detachment before, invest in a good pair of recreational protective eyewear, and then you can do just about anything you want.
But the actual jarring, you know, going up and down, that's not going to make it come. No,
you should be fine as long as it's attached well. You know. Now here's the thing: if you have a little retinal detachment and you haven't seen the doctor yet, and it looks like the superior quadrant of your vision is missing because you have an inferior retinal detachment, or vice versa, you know, the inferior quadrant of your vision is missing because you have a superior retinal detachment, you want to take it very easy until you have the surgery. You don't want to be jumping rope. You don't want to run. You don't want to jump off the roof. You don't want to do anything jarring if you actually have a retina that's detaching until it's fixed, okay?
Well, this was about a year ago, and he did laser it down. He called it tack welded. So he'll go tack weld it for you, so it won't ever come out again, you know.
You should be fine.
Okay. Thank you, Doctor.
All right, Stephen. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right. You're listening to Ask the Doctor, 866-977-4820. We're broadcasting all over the world on the internet, live video streaming, as well as through a multitude of different radio stations. All right, let's go back to the phones. I think we got another Steve on line one. Steve, good morning, Newport Richie.
Hey, Doc, I got a question. When a person has a couple of cataracts removed, is it best to go back to what the kind of vision that they had before they had the cataracts, or up into something altogether different? In other words, like in my case, I'm nearsighted. The gal suggested that being used to being nearsighted, just go back to the way you were. And, of course, the doctor said that, a lot of people like to go to the far-sighted end, you know, so I'm kind of confused.
I mean, I like, when we do cataract surgery, to maximize your distance vision. I like to give you the best distance vision possible. You know, so you can see a tick on a gnat's ass, if I can say that on the radio, okay? So, because now you can lay in bed, watch TV, you can drive your car, you can do everything without glasses. And then, big deal, you put reading glasses on to see up close. Now, if you're nearsighted, it's just the opposite. You can see up close, but you can't see in the distance. So I like maximizing your distance vision because we're really helping you and helping you see in the distance. Now, you can have a multifocal implant put in.
I support that.
And that, okay, because that is expensive.
Yeah, she said the way the way it'd be done now is if I just, because I have astigmatism in my eyes, and that if I just go with the nearsighted, because that's what I'm used to, because I like to do things up close. I do a lot of, like, art stuff and whatnot. But she says I'll still probably, even though my distance will probably be improved compared to what it was, I'll probably still need glasses for that.
The distance. Yeah, so that's not a bad option, especially if you do a lot of things up close. You can ask to be corrected in both eyes about the same. And what you want to shoot for is between a -2 and a -250. Tell them that, because that will enable you to see really clearly at about 35 centimeters, okay?
Okay.
Which is, you know, a good reading distance.
-2 and -250?
Yeah, a -2 to a -250. Now, they can't get it exactly, so tell them to shoot for -2 to 250 in both eyes. Now, remember, you're going to have to wear distance glasses, but your near vision is going to be phenomenal. You'll be able to see the computer, the reading.
Okay.
So a lot of times...
So I'm trying to get back to where I was before I had the cataracts.
Yeah, and
of course, I did need corrective lenses to see it at a distance, okay?
Right.
I'll still need that again?
You still need that unless they do a procedure called monovision where they adjust one for near and one for distance. And I don't recommend that unless you've tried it for contact lenses and were able to adapt to it because it can interfere with your depth perception. So just go for it. Tell them to shoot from -2 to -250 and just be aware that you're going to have to wear glasses for driving. Okay?
Is that okay to go that route?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I think just listening to you, I think that would be best for you because your whole world has been like that up close.
Yeah, and all of a sudden, because I build models,
right,
too, and it requires a lot of fine detail.
Now, like if you were going to hang out with me in Arizona and race Vipers, then I'd say we need to correct your distance, okay?
Okay.
But otherwise, I would do that.
So try to shoot for -2 to 250.
You got it.
Thank you, sir.
All right, take care. Bye-bye. All right, you're listening to Ask the Doctor. I'm Dr. Michael Lange of the Lange Eye Institute in the Villages, Florida, and Fortify Vitamins. Fortify Vitamin Company is a company I started researching and developing vitamins years and years and years ago, and we incorporated about 10 years ago, maybe a little bit longer. These are evidence-based supplements. I've done just tons of clinical studies using patients throughout our practice to develop these supplements. There's nothing in it that's bad for you. I mean, I talk about how the majority of vitamins you buy over the counter are filled with dyes, trans fats, synthetic nutrients that are bad for you, copper, zinc, beta carotene, things that are very bad for you. So we don't put any of that in our supplements, and it's constantly evolving. As a matter of fact, in my hand, if you're watching me on the video right now, this is our new organic blue-green superfood, the new revision, because I listened to you guys and gals. The latest superfood that we had was a little bit too sweet. So we cut the sweetness dramatically. I added some pineapple to it to give it a more robust flavor, cut the stevia back, and we only use part of the stevia twig that is very expensive, so you don't have any aftertaste. So that's called Fortified Blue Green Superfood. It's equivalent to 12 servings of organically grown fruits and vegetables a day. It does not have any FODMAPs. It's gluten-free. It's all certified organic. FODMAPs mean it doesn't have the fruits and vegetables that cause fermentation and bloating in your stomach. All right, phone lines are open. Give me a call. We had a lot of people on hold. They got tired of waiting. I apologize. Call me back at 866-977-4820. 866-977-4820. I'm going to list a few places that actually handle the fortified vitamins in the area. If you're in Gainesville, Florida, you got to go to Quinn Eye Care Center. That's Dr. Kevin Quinn, R. Kevin Quinn. Used to work with me. Great optometric physician. So Quinn Eye Care in Gainesville, Florida. It's right off of Newberry Road. You can't miss it. Dr. Quinn handles all of the fortified vitamins right now. Every single one of them. He has the enzymes, the probiotics, the omega-3, the protein, the macular defense, the super greens. So that's Quinn Eye Care Center. Also, Clark Eye Care Center in Ocala handles all the fortified vitamins right now. Professional Supplement Center in, Professional Supplement Center in Sarasota. That's Palmer Crossing Circle handles it in Sarasota. Gulf Coast Nutrition here in Largo carries it. And certainly Fortify Vitamins. You can always order some Fortify Vitamins, and that's fortify.com. Remember, it's a play on words, F-O-R-T-I-F-E-Y-E, so fortify.com. All right, also want to welcome Dr. Jamie St. Martin to the Lange Eye Institute. She's joined the team about a month ago. Remember, she used to see patients in Ocala, and she's moved her practice in with us at the Lange Eye Institute. So if you saw Dr. Jamie St. Martin, if you're an eye doctor in Ocala and you liked her, then certainly hop, skip, and a jump to the Villages, the Lange Eye Institute in the Villages. We have patients that come from all over the country to see us there. All right, we're going to talk a little bit about the Lange Diet. If you want to learn more about it and actually print a copy of the Lange Diet meal plan, go to fortify.com and go to news, all right? So you'll be able to print it. It's PDF. And it tells you exactly what to have. Like in the morning, it tells you to drink water, spring water, with a tablespoon of apple cider vinegar. This gets the digestive juices and the enzymes, the probiotics all rolling in your stomach. And then breakfast, it tells you what to eat. A lot of eggs with spinach and stuff like this. Protein and vegetables are important for breakfast. Remember, your stomach is very acidic in the morning when you wake up, and your blood sugar is very elevated when you wake up. It is primed for protein and vegetables. Not carbohydrates, not sugar, not orange juice, not a bagel, not toast, not cereal, not oatmeal, all right, which everybody's having right now. Eggs, free-range organic eggs. With kind of like an almond, sauteed in coconut oil. So that's one of the breakfasts you can have. Then at there's a snack which would be like a goat kefir, a goat yogurt, goat cheese, and maybe some almonds or a slice of pineapple. And then it tells you what to eat for lunch. Then it tells you what snack to have, and then it tells you what to have for supper. Remember, one of the meals on the Lange diet plan is the combination of the fortified super protein and the fortified blue green superfood. This is what kickstarts the weight loss, all right? Also, we have the omega-3 and the fortified focus, which elevates the speed of the weight loss and actually improves circulation and lowers inflammation. I've thought about this for years and years and years. I was writing a book. I wrote half the book, and then things changed. So I just finally put it down on paper for you guys and gals. So you can print it out, fortify.com, go to news, and then you'll see Lange Diet Plan, and it's got 1 week of meals. And then just after a week, go back to the next and start over again. And like I said, patients are losing anywhere from 5 to 6 pounds a week up to 14 pounds a week safely. If you don't need to lose weight, it doesn't make you skinnier. It's an anti-aging diet. So for anybody and everybody. And you don't have to follow it to the T. If you follow it to the T, it's designed to help you lose weight. But if you still want to have spaghetti and meatballs every now and then, you can. Just try to follow it as closely as possible. All right. Once again, it's at fortify.com and go to news. So there are some supplements that you will need on this. You'll need the Fortify Super Protein, the Fortify Blue Green Superfood, the Fortify Omega-3, which is Super Omega, and the Fortify Focus. Then you'll need probiotics because every other day in the morning you have probiotics, where every other day you have the apple cider vinegar with mother. So that stretches your probiotics and makes it last twice as long.
And we do make fortified probiotics, which is, I think, about 16 different strains, billions of probiotics. So this is very important. This diet was developed to improve digestion and to improve overall health, to help regulate and normalize blood sugar, to improve retinal efficiency and retinal health. So overall, it's good for your eyes, your brain, your joints, your entire body, your skin. It's called the Lange Diet. Check it out. Fortify.com. Go to news, and you can print it off. All right, phone lines are open. If you got a question regarding your vision, eye care, or a nutritionally related topic, we're getting ready to go to the phone. Actually, getting ready to go take a break. And then after the break, we're going to take some of your phone calls. The number is 866-977-4820. 866-977-4820. I'll see you in about 2.5 minutes. Stay tuned. Good morning. Welcome back to Ask the Doctor. I'm your host, Dr. Michael Lange of the Lange Eye Institute and Fortify Vitamins. If you've got a question regarding your vision, eye care, or a nutritionally related topic, the show is free. Consultation is free. Now, this never replaces a comprehensive eye evaluation or an examination, a medical evaluation. That's if my attorneys are listening. This is for educational purposes only. 866-977-4820. 866-977-4820. Also, before we take the next caller, I do want to mention the Lange Eye Institute. That's myself, Dr. Michael Lange, Dr. Yadi Exposito, Dr. Jamie St. Martin. We're involved in the first of its type early detection Alzheimer's study through your eye care provider. There are three things that we found now that are a telltale sign of Alzheimer's: cortical cataracts, nerve fiber layer atrophy, and drusenoid bodies in the retina. So we have some technology now, something called the Anitis RHA, that they can detect all of this earlier than any other technology. So we do an examination, we do the Anitis RHA and a sophisticated OCT scan of your retina to determine. If you're going to pay cash for this, if you don't have insurance that covers it, it's $200 for everything. That's not bad. Now, if we find that you're a candidate to develop this Alzheimer's, then we're going to send you upstairs to see Dr. John Podlatsky. Dr. Podlatsky is also working with us in this early detection Alzheimer's study. And it was developed by a Dr. Thomas Lewis, who's pretty amazing. I mean, he's got degrees from all over, a degree from MIT. He's a PhD. He's had training from Harvard School of Public Health. Like I said, he's got a degree, I think it's in inorganic and physical chemistry from MIT, and then he also has a degree from Worcester Polytech Institute. So that's Dr. Thomas Lewis. He's written some books on Alzheimer's, and he is kind of the lead doctor in this that's helping put all of this together. And then ultimately, what we want to do is a natural protocol if you're at risk of Alzheimer's, a natural nutritional protocol and lifestyle changes to help ward off the potential of this occurring. And if you have it, to maybe slow it down, can we reverse it? Some people say we can through proper nutrition. All right, let's go to the phones. First question from Susan in Silver Springs. Good morning.
Good morning to you, Doctor. Welcome back.
Thank you.
It's a cold. I'm in Silver Springs, so it's probably cooler here than where you are. Anyways, I have a question about collagen. Mm-hmm. I was taking a collagen protein, and I was using it with your protein and your fruit and vegetable powder.
Right.
And I was from Dr. Axe, and I know you, Dr. Mm-hmm. Josh Axe, you mentioned him, that he was one of the only other doctors that used the A2C.
Right, the protein, right, right.
Right. Well, now his collagen has added bone broth.
Mm-hmm.
And I have problems with my intestines right now that I can't really have bone broth because of, depending how long they cook it and everything, it can have something in there that causes more problems for me.
So yep.
Do you have collagen without bone broth, or do you know of anyone that does?
No, that's a really good question. We do not, and Dr. Axe is the one that has this collagen protein. Remember, collagen is like the most abundant protein in our bodies. I mean, you know, gelatin, all right? Knox gelatin is collagen, basically, all right? So, And this is good for, I mean, there's a lot of kind of lame studies that promote it being good for almost everything. But we do know it improves skin health and hair health, your nails and your skin. It's supposed to help reduce some of the joint pain. I'm still not a big advocate, just like I'm not huge on omega-7 yet. The whole collagen thing, I'm still not big on it because I haven't seen enough good studies. You know, there's a lot of great studies with the omega-3 concentrate. I mean, the omega-3, a lot of great studies on the whey protein concentrate from grass-fed New Zealand cows. But I think that a lot of people are jumping on this bandwagon right now because, you know, there's so much competition in the omega-3 arena. There's so much competition in the whey protein arena that these doctors can't make the money that are selling it that they used to. So they're trying to come out with something different. And I think that's one of the reasons people are promoting this collagen and bone broth. You know, it does have some legitimate benefits, but, you know, is there a lot of hype behind it? I don't know. I don't know enough about it. Like I said, there's not enough good studies, Susan, for me to really get behind it 100% yet.
Okay.
Now, I'm going to constantly stay abreast of this, and if it's something I think is legit and the majority of the public can benefit from it, you know, Fortify will come out with something like that. But at this point, it's still, in my opinion, too early.
Okay. Well, I'm more concerned right now. I've been losing a lot of weight on a specific diet I have to be on, and I'm concerned about my bones and my muscles, and I always thought collagen was possibly good for that, but I don't.
Well, the best thing is sunshine. And I've talked about this before. You got to get 20 to 30 minutes of sun every day with no sunscreen front and back. And then weight-bearing exercises, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Eat your dark green leafy vegetables, but they have to be cooked or gently steamed or juiced because that breaks down the bioavailability, releasing the nutrients, including the calcium, the lutein, the zeaxanthin, from the dark green leafy vegetables. If you're going to take something to help osteopenia and osteoporosis, then you want to take something, a type of calcium that absorbs into the bone and doesn't circulate and cause calcification of the arteries and the venules. So that would be something. Douglas Laboratories makes one I like called OsteoGuard plus Ipraflavone because it has a type of calcium combined with phosphorus, boron, vitamin K, Ipraflavone, magnesium, vitamin D3. All these things help it absorb. And I hate it when doctors just tell their patients to go buy, you know, 1,500 units of calcium at CVS, all right, not to knock CVS, because that's way too much, and it's not the right formula, and it just causes calcification, increasing your risk of macular degeneration, carotid artery stenosis, heart attacks, strokes, all of this stuff. So that's why you got to, you know, see a nutritional in-tune doctor.
Well, I do see Dr. Podlasky.
Right.
The other thing, so what was the name of the person that sells the OsteoGuard?
Oh, it's Douglas Laboratories, and you can get it at the Fortify Vitamin Center right there on 17th Street.
Oh,
and we do carry it at the Lange Eye Institute because I get so many patients with macular degeneration that are taking the wrong type of calcium. So we have it available for them. It's not my company, and it's a good product. It's called OsteoGuard plus Ipraflavone. You can only get it through doctor's offices, but since I own the Fortify Vitamins, we are able to sell it through Fortify Vitamins.
Great. Well, I'll get it at your 17th Street one.
All right, Susan, take care.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
You too.
All right, you're listening to Ask the Doctor. 1-866-977-4820, Atlanta, Montgomery, all of Florida. Give me a call if you got a question. We're going to a Montgomery, Alabama caller right now. Let's see. Nancy in Montgomery, Alabama. Good morning.
Good morning. I have a question. I have glaucoma. My mom had it, and I have been going to my ophthalmologist for 20 probably plus years, and I would see him every 6 months and every 3 months, and now he's got me down to 2 months. I'm losing peripheral vision, and he hasn't told me to take anything for it or given me any information. I don't know if I'm just because of my age, and I only wear glasses to read, and usually I use my readers. I don't need it for anything except up close, but I can tell, like at church in the hymnal, I can see that in the mornings, but as the day goes on, I need it if I'm reading something to tell an 8 from a 6 or something close like that. Is there anything I could take that would slow that down? He says my cataracts are not growing. I don't need to have the surgery yet.
Well, first of all,
I don't understand why in the last 3 months my eyes have gotten so much worse.
Well, Nancy, first of all, you're 79. You're young.
Yes.
That's the new 59, okay? So you're not old, so don't say that. Now, second of all, let me ask you this. How much do you weigh?
About 137 to 140.
Good. So you're not overweight. Excellent. Unless you're 2 feet tall. So I think it's very important, anybody with glaucoma, to do cardiovascular exercise, all right? So get on a treadmill, elliptical trainer, go for a fast, brisk walk, swim, row.
I can't do that. I have a balance problem.
Well, could you ride
a... I had to stop going to the gym. I could do something like rowing or something, but I can't do anything right. Because I walk now with a cane.
So you could get on
if I'm barefoot, I can walk. But if I wear shoes and everything, I'm afraid to walk without a cane. Mm-hmm.
So you could do a stationary bicycle then, couldn't you?
Yes, that's what I was thinking about.
Good. Invest in a stationary bicycle, put it in front of the TV, do it for 20 minutes a day. Cardiovascular exercise can bring the pressure down in your eye by as much as 30%, okay?
Ooh, okay.
Now, what I also put all my glaucoma patients on is a combination of our Fortify Super Omega and our Fortify Focus. And the reason for that is that combination lowers inflammation in the eye and the entire body, and it improves circulation to every part of the body. So two Fortify Super Omegas and one Fortify Focus combined with cardiovascular exercise. And then it's crucial, if you're losing peripheral vision, they have to make sure that your pressure in your eye is normal or low, okay? If you're continuously losing vision, and they document this with their visual field test that you should be having done twice a year, okay?
I do. I have that done.
And if you're losing vision, then that means, that means your pressure is not low enough. What's your last pressure reading? Do you know?
No, he didn't tell me, but usually he'll tell me it's 19 or 20. Sometimes it's a different, like a 19, one eye, 20 in the other eye.
Well, when we look at that pressure, and if you're having progressive damage to your optic nerve and loss of peripheral vision, that pressure's not low enough. So oftentimes, okay. We want to lower it to 10 or lower sometimes. But it all depends. I'm at a disadvantage because I don't have your OCTs, your visual fields. I don't know the thickness of your cornea. So I don't have that in front of me. And I'm sure your ophthalmologist is more than competent. But remember, you've been seeing this doctor forever. There's nothing wrong with second opinions, okay? So
that's what my husband said. He goes to another ophthalmologist and he wanted me to...
Absolutely. I'd find a good optometrist, optometric physician, or ophthalmologist. All of those type of eye doctors can treat glaucoma. But maybe it's time just for a second opinion. If you go to get a second opinion, they say the same thing, then go back to the doctor that you've been seeing forever if you still like him or her. But, yeah, second opinion is a good idea because maybe they're not seeing something. Maybe they've been just a little bit lax because they've been knowing you forever. Who knows? But if you're losing peripheral vision, they have to bring the pressure down lower. And this is one time I recommend surgery. If you can't get it down naturally and with medication drops, then that's where surgical intervention. There's a lot of good laser procedures and stents that can be done now to lower the pressure and preserve your vision. You know, if you're 95 years old, I wouldn't be worried about it. But you're 79, you got another 30 years ahead of you. So you got to be concerned if you're starting to lose vision, okay?
Okay, well, I certainly enjoy your program. I'm glad you're finally on our station.
You know, my grandparents and my mom is from Montgomery, Alabama.
Oh, really?
Yeah, my mom grew up on Augusta Avenue right there in Cloverdale.
Oh, okay. I know where that is. Yes.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, and I've really learned a lot from you. I will get on your website because I've jotted down notes, and I do need to look at your website to get these correctly. And do you buy them over the web like you do on Amazon or something? Can you?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. At fortify.com. And remember the little code I gave you. LEC 20%. That's going to give you 20% off when you buy three or more Fortify items. You
get LEC 20%?
Yep, LEC 20%. So when you go to checkout on the website, there's a little coupon code section. You'll see it, and just type that in, boom, and you'll get it at a day from Florida. You'll get the products. And I stand behind everything 100%. If you get something and you're not satisfied with it, you send it back. We'll give you a full refund. It's as simple as that.
Okay, great. Thank you so much.
All right, Nancy, take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, Montgomery, Alabama, good morning, and thanks for tuning in. If you've got a question, give me a call, 866-977-4820. Also, Atlanta, Georgia, I think we're on 640 WGST. I'd really love to see if we're coming in loud and clear. So anybody out there in Atlanta, help me out. Give us a call at 866-977-4820. That's 866-977-4820. And that's WGST 640 in Atlanta. And certainly, I don't want to leave the Sky listeners out, the Sky 97.3 FM. They've been listening for 20 years after this radio show. So that's been one of the longest standing stations I've been on. And certainly 8:20 a.m. here in Tampa Bay. Hits almost the entire state of Florida. We get a lot of people up in the panhandle that hear us from 8:20 a.m. All right. So remember, if you're interested in coming to the Lange Eye Institute to enroll in this early detection Alzheimer's study that we're doing, our prevention study, I should say, contact us at the Lange Eye Institute. I'm going to give you the phone number for the Lange Eye Institute. That phone number is 352. Wow. I don't know the phone number at Lange Eye Institute. I got too many numbers to remember. Oh, well, you can Google Lange Eye Institute and get the phone number. I think it's 753-4014. That's it. It came to my head. So 352-753-4014. Lange Eye Institute, we take just about every insurance. We still take cash. Remember, we do some specific tests to look for the earliest telltale signs in the eye of Alzheimer's. And remember, the key is early detection, just like the key for eye disease is early detection. I have people that I see that have early macular degeneration. We adjust their diet, put them on the appropriate supplements, and I have seen reversal of many forms of macular degeneration. All right. Phone lines are open, 866-977-4820. One more time, I'm going to give you the phone number for 4 to 5 vitamins. Get a piece of paper, write this down. Anything I talk about, you can call them. They usually know what I talk about. That's 866-503-9746. 4 to 5 vitamins, write this down, 866-503-9746. Just got a shout-out from Hyperlater and HyperUp. We're coming in live through this video, and they're watching me. So that's newstalkflorida.com. That's a software company. I got to tell you, you got to check them out, hyperup.com. It's a new way to actually market your businesses. It's a really cool company. I think it's going to be big. So they're actually texting me saying that, what a beautiful face. All right. We're getting ready to go to the phones here in just a second. Be patient. We got a lot of people piling up. Remember, Dr. Kevin Quinn, Quinn Eye Care, has all of the fortified vitamins in Gainesville. Clark Eye Care in Ocala. Gulf Coast Nutrition in Largo. Professional Supplement Center in Sarasota. Certainly go to Fortify Vitamins, and you can actually try it before you buy it in Fortify Vitamins right there on 17th Street. That's 1510 Southwest 17th Street. You can go into Fortify Vitamins. You can have a sample of the protein, a sample of the greens. We'll mix them together with some almond milk or coconut milk, and that can be your lunch or breakfast. So come have a lunch or breakfast on Dr. Michael Lange and Fortify Vitamins so you can try it before you buy it. All right. We're going to the phone. Let's see. Molly in Largo, good morning.
Good morning. Thank you. I have two questions. The first one is very, very quick. I drink raw milk, which is, right from the cow, but just a little bit of it because it raised my cholesterol up to 260. So now I'm cutting way back on that, but I'm doing more coconut products. Will that keep my cholesterol very high?
Well, I mean, coconut's two totally different. Coconut milk is good, but it has no protein in it, all right? I love raw milk, all right? The only problem is you need to get A2 raw milk, and that comes from Jersey cows. And I mentioned Tom, what is it, Sandhill Farm and Archer. I don't have his phone number now. If Tom's listening, you could call in and give your phone number. But he delivers, so try to get raw milk that's from A2 cows, all right?
All right, I'll find out.
But therefore, it's not been genetically mutated. The beta casein protein is not A1. Or get goat's milk, raw goat's milk. It's actually even more digestible than raw cow's milk. Now, you got to remember, it's going to stay on the label for your pet's use, not for human consumption, okay?
Yeah, I get all this stuff from a co-op, and they have a very local farm. I'll find out what kind of cows they use.
Well, A2 cows, right? Now, you got to remember, more people have had trouble eating spinach, raw spinach from E. coli, than anybody from drinking raw milk. So raw milk is great because the digestive enzymes, the probiotics, the protein hasn't been altered by 300 degrees, okay, which is bad. So I love raw milk. As far as your cholesterol goes, you know, Molly, I wouldn't be that concerned about cholesterol. I'd be more concerned about C-reactive protein, triglycerides, homocysteine, body weight, and things like that. Remember, cholesterol has some protective aspects. Now, obviously, if your cholesterol is super high and the ratio is off, then maybe we got to be concerned. But I think cholesterol has been overblown. I think cholesterol has been overblown to sell a lot of cholesterol medications, to be honest with you. All right?
Yeah, so I shouldn't worry too much about 260.
Well, I always tell this story. My mom's cholesterol for the last 40 years has been between 300 and 350, all right?
Okay.
My mom's 89 years old. My mom and dad are both 89. They drove down from New Orleans, visited me for Christmas. My mom still plays tennis 3 days a week.
Wow.
She has never had a stroke or a heart attack, never been in the hospital, never had any surgery. 300 to 350 cholesterol. She's drank whole milk all her life, hates skim milk, eats a lot of eggs. All right, so I think you'll find that some interesting things coming down the pike regarding cholesterol. I'm not a big advocate of cholesterol medications. Obviously, you have to do what your primary care physician tells you to do, but there are other ways of becoming, anti-aging ways and other ways of being healthy without altering cholesterol too much.
Okay.
Now, coconut water can bring your cholesterol down, all right? My Fortify Focus, the pill I developed that has the astaxanthin in it. So astaxanthin, 6 milligrams, can bring cholesterol and triglycerides along with C-reactive protein down.
Mm-hmm.
Omega-3 fish oil helps bring inflammation and triglycerides down. It helps bring your HDL up. So it helps get your ratio of cholesterol good. You want that HDL to go up and LDL to go down. So if you have a higher HDL, it really doesn't matter if you have a 260 cholesterol. Also, cardiovascular exercise will bring the HDL up and the LDL down. So if you practice all of these things, I wouldn't be too concerned about the raw milk. Now, you do have to be concerned about raw milk, about how clean the environment is it comes from, because you worry about, since it's not pasteurized, the potential for bacteria. But, you know, that's a gamble if you're going to drink it.
Yeah, they've never had a recall from this farm, the co-op that I use, so...
Right.
Okay, question number two, and I'll be right to the point. I'm 66, 5'4", I weigh 125 pounds. My eyes have been perfectly normal up until last year. They found the good kind of glaucoma. My cornea is thin, so he got me on the eye drops once a day.
Mm-hmm.
My original pressure was 26. Now he's got it down to 19.
Mm-hmm.
There has been absolutely no peripheral vision lost at all. He wants me to have the SLT laser surgery.
Mm-hmm.
I'm scared to death to let them do anything to my eye. Is there anything? He wants to get away from the drops because they cause, like, clunking and gooping, and my eyes burn and get irritated from it. What do you think about the SLT surgery?
Selective laser trabeculoplasty is very safe, right? We do a lot of it. It's very safe, but I always try to treat it medically and naturally first. And if we get side effects, and your side effects from the drops are a lot of clunkiness, they could always try some different drops first, all right?
Well, we did already.
Yeah, then I think he's probably right. I think probably the laser is a good option. It really is. And it's safe, it's painless, you'll do fine, all right?
Oh, there's nothing to, I can't go blind or anything, right?
Well, any type of surgical procedure has potential side effects, but in the hands of a competent ophthalmologist, SLT, you'll be fine, okay? You'll be fine. But that sounds like that's the best option, and it's the safest alternative from a surgical procedure to see if it works, okay?
Okay, all right. How long will it last?
It could last 3 years, it could last till you die. Who knows?
Oh, okay.
All right.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Doctor. I like your show.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right. Let's go to Sunny in Cleartown, Cedartown, Georgia. What part of Georgia?
Cedartown. It's northwest of Atlanta.
So you must be hearing us on 640 AM?
Well, I can't get you. My husband did hear you on an Atlanta radio station yesterday and heard the advertisement on 640, but I'm listening on the web.
Okay, good deal. So what's your question?
So
so I have a father with macular degeneration, and so I've tried to do, you know, eat more vegetables and do what I can to keep my eyes healthy.
Right.
I'm hypothyroid, I'm 53,
mm-hmm.
I'm not overweight, but I'm wondering specifically for people with hypothyroidism, no gallbladder, what do I need to do, because
Hang on. I'm going to take this off the hold on, okay? I'm going to take this off the radio because we got to go.
All
right. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. I'll be back next week for another live show of Ask the Doctor. I'm Dr. Michael Lang. Have a great day, and God bless you.